We are now live, actually, and obviously I would like to start asking you, how did you actually arrive to the Phonebloks vision and project? What's the story behind this?
Okay. Well, it started basically when I had this old Canon camera, just like this compact camera you take on your holiday, and it broke. So naturally, I wanted to fix it. So I took it apart and I noticed all these good components, like hundreds of them, like a good battery, flash, and everything was still working perfectly, except for the lens motor. That one was broken. So I thought, okay, let's get a new part and fix it. But that wasn't possible. And Canon basically told me you just have to get a new one. And at that point, I thought, well, that's basically how it always goes with electronics. When something is broken, you just throw it away. But for instance, if your bike has a flat tire or something, you fix it. You don't throw away the bike. So, and then I looked it up. This creates an enormous amount of e-waste, and it's just bad. So I thought, let's see if I can do anything about it to change this, or I don't know, see if I can bring any help at this topic.
Yeah. So, and when did you actually thought that a social campaign like the one that you designed was key to bring this discussion? Because, you know, everything about the discussion about these kind of topics was probably already going on, but nobody succeeded like you did to design this powerful, you know, vision and this powerful social campaign behind all this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so for me, it's sort of went step by step. So my first initial idea was to just make a phone that can last like 100 years, and that's it. But then I thought, I also like that technology evolves. So from that point, I went to a modular phone, and then I was like, modular is really complex to make, so I need to gather a lot of companies. But companies are, they don't really take me serious, probably. So I thought, let's just do it the other way around, gather a lot of people and show it serious to those companies. So that's why I set up this campaign, just because that felt like the right way to take this project to a next step, instead of just an idea, make it more than just an idea.
When I've read some of some interviews of you also, and it seems that when you joined your efforts with Motorola, they were already into something in a way similar. So it's just, it's like they were working on a similar concept, and then they found you and the community behind the Phonebloks, and then you decided to join efforts. Is that right?
Yeah, so basically they were working on something similar, and they were really working on the technical side of it, and I was more working on the visionary side with the people and stuff. So they were like, would you like to come and work with us on our project? But I didn't really like that so much, because for me the key thing is to get this phone on the right way, like modular, open source, and made to last. And I was afraid that I'm going to work at their project. It's just like I have just one guy with one opinion. It's sort of easily, yeah, just let Dave talk and we'll do it whatever we want. So in this way, now I have like, we work together. So now it's not just me criticizing them or giving them feedback, but it's like the entire community. And I guess that's what I like mostly about this project, that the people are involved in the development process, because this is sort of never really done on a scale like this with such a large company. And I think that's what I'm most excited about, to actually get that thing done.
Is it only Motorola working on this, or you are looking also to engage with other companies or make it like an alliance, like it was for Android, for example?
No, for me, Phonebloks is not a company that is building a phone, because we're not good in building phones. Other companies can do that better. For me, Phonebloks is really the vision. We want this phone, and we're looking for partners who can actually make this. So right now we partner up with Motorola, but we are looking for more partners. Like, the more the better, I guess. The more people, the more partners, the better the project gets.
What's the, you know, the role of open source was in the original idea or just came after? So it's a modular and then open source, or you really envisioned this product like as an open source piece of work? What's the role of open source?
Yeah, so I'm always really impressed by WordPress, how they make things, that they sort of set up a standardization and then people can make like these plugins. And actually, these plugins sort of make the platform so cool because then you have like a ton of things to use, and that's what I really like. That if the whole world can work on it, we can make so much more stuff than just one company. So that's why I'm also really keen on breaking this market sort of open, that everybody can participate. Any company, startup, developer can build stuff for it. And I think you get a much more richer ecosystem of things that are made. And like, for instance, maybe biodegradable blocks would increase enormously instead of just plastic, because the community wants this.
I'm curious to know what's the actual way of making Phonebloks an independent actor. Like, are you going to incorporate this in a company or foundation? I don't know. What's your point of view? What's your next step on this? It's now just you, or more of an inclusive project where people can join, like volunteering or things like that?
Yeah. So right now we want to launch this week online. So we're building really this online platform place where people can share their thoughts, ideas, and discuss about the project. And we can post questions and just let people answer them, let them give the best answer, they can vote, so the best answer pops up. So in this way that we can really, because we don't want to post a question and read 500 answers, we want to sort of filter out the best ones. And this feedback we can share with the companies that work on this phone, so right now Motorola, and we say, hey, the community says this, maybe you should do this and this, and they will say, oh, we've been developing this, what do you guys think about it? So in this way, we are right now really focused on doing this. And after that, we also want to definitely set it up, I don't know, as a foundation. I haven't really looked it up yet, to be really independent for like the everything. We're just a vision. We want to keep it independent, and we just want to make sure it comes there on the right way, this phone.
So it's more of a co-design, synchronizing, let's say, managing all these co-design process and trying to be like the middleman between the vision from the community and the manufacturing companies that wants to build this product.
Yeah, I think, well, honestly, when I started this project, I had no idea what we're going to do in the future. But right now, considering where we are and what Motorola is doing and what the people want, I think that's the best position for us, because on the one side, you have a lot of people that want to help. And a lot of people just have good knowledge and resources. And you have the company who actually built it. But they sort of don't connect. So I guess the best thing to do is to connect those two worlds to make sure they can work together and get people involved in the design process.
Can I ask you one? I think there is an interesting point in this, because probably Motorola or other companies, they have the technical understanding and knowledge about how to design consumer electronics, and so the point to me is really being able to connect also the engineers and the technical touchy people that is in the community, and then maybe can have a say in moving forward with a vision that is really genuine and in line with the initial vision that you had. So yeah. The danger right now is maybe that the technical understanding coming from companies can in a way overcome the original vision of the product, and maybe you end up just being like the minimum common denominator to just feedbacks coming from the community. It's something that maybe we should try to avoid.
Yeah, so that's what this feeling I really had if it was just me working at Motorola on their project. But right now, because they said we're going to do it, so that's the cool thing about this project, I think, that they're going to develop in the open. So normally they would do this secretly, like for 2 years, and then publish it or not. And right now, because of Phonebloks had so many supporters, we were able to trick them out of their secret hole and just say, okay, throw it out in the open. So if, I guess, if they make a bad decision, for instance, they would choose, I don't know, wrong side of plastic, which is just bad. And normally it was just me saying, hey, I don't like this. But now it's like all these people are sort of giving feedback and say, no, don't do this. And I think that's sort of a powerful position, because that in this way the people can sort of guide the project and they don't want to have the bad publicity of saying, oh, we're still going to do it anyway.
In a way, it's like that with this huge amount of followers of the campaign, you actually made some customer and market validation of the product. So I think also companies are interested in producing a product that is appealing to people. And you did a great job on explaining to people that they should, I think they should ask for such kind of product. So again, that was the big, how behind your campaign, I guess. So getting back to the actual Phonebloks activities and roadmap, I think that we should try to clarify the community in what ways will be possible to join and give feedbacks, maybe more than just interactive with the platform. But that's, I don't know, maybe you can explain us what's the roadmap in, regarding Phonebloks as an organization and in what ways people could actually help make this work.
Yeah, so the first thing we're working on now is building, like we got a lot of people that are just shooting mails at us with IDs, which they have, and feedback, and you should do this and should do this. But it's like impossible to read them all and filter them. So what we're doing now is create this place where people can filter themselves. So it's sort of like Stack Overflow. Do you know the website? Mm-hmm. You post a question, people post answers, and then they vote up the best answer. So you don't have to read all the answers. You can just see what is like the community thinks is the best answer. So we're sort of integrating that into this online platform. And in this way, we really want to, so in the beginning, we want to let people participate. What kind of blocks would you like on a phone? How would you see this? For instance, maybe in the future, we're going to choose the name of this phone. Like, what would the people like? And in the future, we also want that to be the place for the hardware. So in the winter, we want to release this module developer kit so that people can start prototyping their blocks and see what they're making and how it's going. And also create a place online where people can share those things they make and work on it together.
So it will be possible also to work on the actual, with the limits given with the tools, but in the actual design of the product, like designing modules and things like that.
Yeah, so in the end, the main goal still is that everybody can design modules. So companies, startups, I don't know. But so in the winter, we really want to, now the thing basically is that if you want to develop hardware software, it's nowadays it's pretty reasonable to do. We have the tools, we have the programs, but developing hardware so small on this scale is pretty difficult, like managing to make these blocks. So we're also thinking if we need to make the tools or how can we make it easier for the people to develop blocks. Like, which is in software now. It was much more difficult 10 years ago than it is now in terms of the tools we have. So that's also sort of this first research. And like, we present the specifications to the people and we say, okay, these are the specifications to this platform. Let's build your blocks. And then we can get feedback from them, like it's really difficult or not, or what kind of tools would you like, or what would make it better. So in this way, we really want to start early by inviting people and work on this so we can see how they manage it or don't.
Yeah, I have a very last question then. It's about how, if I would like to know if you already, maybe it's too early in the project, but if you guys already, maybe with Motorola as well, have wondered about the impact that such kind of product could have in the actual manufacturing process, like the supply chain and distributed manufacturing. Is there any discussion or there any idea ongoing in this in, from this point of view?
Yeah. So that's sort of what I meant to say earlier, or like last minute, that right now to develop like a block, you really have to think about large scale, and you have to really set up a manufacturing process in a factory that you can produce thousands, millions. So if you want to sort of develop your own blocks or like on a smaller scale, we haven't really got the tools yet. And 3D printing is a nice tool for that, but it's not really evolved that much. So we're also looking into that world, how we can integrate those tools like this 3D printing mechanism to make modules or to make blocks easier. So you don't have to always set up a huge factory to build blocks. So that's something we just have in the back of our mind. How can we manage this for the people?
Interesting, because in this way you actually can kind of change the role, the overall role of the manufacturer. So actually, also a player like Motorola or every manufacturer that can join the alliance also needs to probably rethink a little bit its role in the overall value chain, like not just producing pieces, but maybe like, I don't know, designing pieces or just because you what you mentioned is nice, because in this way you could have like a manufacturing process that is really, really, really distributed, actually in the hands of the end user, basically.
So, but that the difficult thing is the tools aren't ready for that yet. So it's sort of we have to parallel of develop those or see possibilities of what people are doing. But I think we just have to start, right? And it will come.